Also Rako Vytis, and today we'll see how heavy of a dumbbells you lift. I know, these are so old, I have it like from ages ago and I just use them for warm up. I'm thinking about getting the heavier ones because I want to add something to my calisthenics training. So I think it is the fifth episode of me reviewing 2019's anime I watched, because there was like three of Dr. Stone's I made and there was one of Kimetsu no Yaiba. So okay, how heavy are the dumbbells you lift, or Danberu 9 kilo Moteru? It's I think it means the same, just in Japanese. So basically, this anime was not even that famous, but I got to know it by the YouTuber I watched, the Jacked Blade, and I think majority of you watching this video is found out this anime the same way, because he just forced us to watch it, and it was, I could say, really unique and good, because first of all, for those who haven't seen it, so it's anime about like there is the two girls from the high school. One girl is already fit and she is like obsessed with training, and the other girl is getting fat, she wants to eat a lot. Her appetite is like Goku's, and she sees that she is getting fat and she wants to lose this fat, and she starts to go into the gym. Basically, at the beginning, she was training just to compensate the food she eats. But later on, she starts liking training from itself. She meets that her trainer. These two girls are trained. The Hibiki Sakura and the other girl is Akemi, I think. So these two girls are attending to the gym. These girls are have complete different personalities, and they were never friends before. In this gym, they become friends and start training, and they are being trained by their personal trainer, Machia. And this trainer is you have to see at least few episodes, because I mean, he destroys every episode. He destroys at least 5 t-shirts, because he's from one of these bodybuilders who, without clothes, looks like he is super huge, he's super muscular, and actually he is. But when he is putting his tracksuit on, he becomes really just fit guy, but a small guy. And he always then flexes, but his tracksuit is being destroyed. And it's like a comical thing in this anime, because he destroys his tracksuits every day, and I don't know from where he gets more. So basically, if you wanna see cute girls attending the gym, you can go and watch it. And if you're a girl or woman yourself, you can watch it just to motivate yourself to train, because this anime is just about training. The main thing is a lot of exercise and active lifestyle. And these girls like learning. Later on, the squad is increasing. They will be 4 girls and 1 actually teacher, so there's a 5 women squad, and they're just like training, and there's all different story how they meet, and there's a lot of like mini fun things. And basically what is so unique about this anime is so that every food they eat, like the Sakura Hibiki, she loves food, and like she eats candy, and there's on the screen the calories, how much calories have candy. She eats a burger and we see how many calories are in it, so we can learn a lot more about this a lot of foods and how many calories are in them. We don't know, it's like extra thing. And then the trainer showing the exercise, there is like a whole tutorial how to do it, and they show the variations, and even you can repeat it and do yourself this exercise. And that's why I like it. Maybe that's how I got the idea to do exercise at the end of all of my videos. So, and yes, at the end of every episode there is a mini workout too. So yes, the anime just about being motivated to train, and there's a lot of legit facts, like about diet, how you should eat to lose weight. There's very good explanation that you don't need to go on the extreme diet. You can just manage the calories you eat and try to eat healthy, and that's how you can get fit. And you can get information like about the fitness things, like bulking, cutting, the healthy eating, the exercise. And I could say this is the anime I never saw before, because it is so unique. The story is just about training and going to gym, and I would recommend it just because it's a really unique anime. And that's, I think, it. I am not going very deep into this, because you have to see it yourself. It's there is no very big story. There is just like there is a lot of things, but you must see. I don't want to spoil anything, but there is later on like the copy of Arnold Schwarzenegger. There is he likes can run on the water. There is a lot of like this anime is really almost very very logical, and there is no like superpowers, but there is some things that you can think, what am I watching? But basically there will be arm wrestling fights, there will be idol competition, and these girls will try to become idols. There will be a lot of things, but I think what motivates is that these girls are working their asses out, and they like to train, they like to spend time active. Not like most of the high school girls who now do with vape things and smoking things, but these girls are spending time active, and you can get so many ideas from them. So I don't know if there will be a new season, but there is manga, so I am thinking to read it, and because it is interesting what's going to be next. So yeah, that's my thoughts about this anime. And one more thing I wanted to say, that King and Ashura manga, there is like crossover between this anime, Danberu Nankila Moteru, and the King and Ashura manga. Because there is the same creator, and in this anime you can see a lot of characters from actually King and Ashura, and there is not happening things that happens in the like King and Ashura anime, but it is the same world. So you can, if you read the manga, you can find the characters you saw before, and that's cool. And the thing is that I started reading King and Ashura after I watched this anime. I could say there is really good fights in that manga, and there is like really I love Toyota, who is so good at technique. But I could say this artist of this anime and these mangas, like King and Ashura and Danberu Nankila Moteru, are really unique designs of the characters. So yes, I'm slowly reading it now. I am at that part where Toyota did something and became berserk like, and it's really interesting what will be more, because I read about 14 chapters I think now just. And at the end I wanna say that in the Danberu Nankila Moteru there is so good animation parts where they like make Hibiki Super Saiyan, or they make like these faces like from, there is like this anime you watch and you're thinking, is this anime or not? Because you are feeling like you are not watching an anime. Just because you are watching in Japanese, you are thinking like, oh, that's anime. But I don't know if it really is. But then there is some parts where will make it extra anime, because they make like these animation styles from One Punch Man or from Dragon Ball, or like they make these unique things that you will fall in love with it. So yes, unique anime, and now before I say goodbye, we will definitely do some exercise.
Now I say goodbye, press the like button and subscribe, and Macho-san will show you some exercise.
みんなさっき僕が言ったこと覚えてるかな膝が体の前に出過ぎないように注意しよう準備はいいかなそれじゃあやってみよう1骨盤を下げていくイメージでお尻が床と平行か、やや下になるまでしゃがんだら、元の姿勢に戻る。テンポよく繰り返して、目標10回。
そろそろ辛くなってきた。
まだまだいけるわ。
6、頑張って。7、8、9、10。
これを毎日3セットやれば、ダイエットにも効果的だよ。それじゃあ今日も、
ナイスバイク。